Okay. Fine. Fine, 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 fine. 38-20. I don't know sports anymore. None of you know sports anymore. Yeah, like, that is exactly how we all predicted it. Here's the thing. Things are getting real now. Because not only did you dominate this supposed top defense in the country, you, in the first half, you did almost anything you wanted to. And in the second half, Riley's like, brah. You just like, run, we can just run the ball and try killing the clock. Now, you would think that'd be crazy with OU's defense. But, you know, they gave up 20 points tonight, which is really good for this defense. Is it as simple as having Trey Brown and Trey Norwood out there at corner? Getting Neville Gallimore back. Maybe Kenny Hill just sucks. I think there's a little bit of truth to all that. Everything pieced together, that's what you get. There were moments that you go, wait, huh? But then there are moments you go, oh, great. And you're happy with the end result. Let's just break it down. Number one, OU is going to be in the top four on Tuesday because, you know, there's a couple teams in the top four that got their asses whipped today. We'll talk about that momentarily. Baker Mayfield had a very solid afternoon, evening. He has once again solidified his place in the Heisman Trophy voting, and it will go on to next week because OU plays Kansas. They're not losing to Kansas. And Rodney Anderson had, like, see, last week it was Marquise Brown, and this week it's Rodney Anderson, which it continues the trend of anyone on this offense can take over and dominate. It's not one guy. It's brilliant. It's wonderful. It's excellent. And look, I know a lot of you out there, especially on Twitter, were going nuts in the second half when Riley was playing conservative. I get it. And y'all were expecting the other shoe to drop, right? You were expecting, we can't trust this defense, we can't do this, we can't do that. But I try to look at each game as its own unique animal. TCU was not going to be able to move the ball that easily on this defense, believe it or not. This defense was playing solid tonight. And it helps when you have two guys out there at corner. And look, Trey Norwood was making competitive plays. He got beat one-on-one sometimes. It happens, but he was competitive. He was going for the ball. There were times he got penalties. But you know what? I'd rather have a freshman out there who's trying, who's putting out some effort, and who's healthy. Because you saw the result tonight. And Robert Barnes played a lot tonight, and I think Robert Barnes he's still got a long ways to go. Will Johnson made his presence known in the second half, which is great. But, like, it's just little things with this defense we saw tonight. Third and long, you get stops. It's not about turning the ball over. You want to see more turnover, sure. But it was like, with this defense, you couldn't get off the field on third and long. And they were able to do that tonight. When they go for it on fourth down, you were able to get a stop and turnover on downs. That's what we've been, that's what's been driving the entire fan base crazy all season since the Baylor game. And tonight, for the first time since, what, the Ohio State game, maybe the Texas game to some respect, but it was just, holy crap, the defense made some plays. Simple plays. Got in the quarterback's face. Got a hand up. Knocked a pass down. That's all we ask. That's all we ask. The turnovers will come eventually. You almost did. I don't even think they forced a turnover. It doesn't matter. Because they made plays when they met. Now, that first quarter was a little rough. Early part is like, oh boy, here we go. Then things settled down. So did the offense. crowd was really great in the first half, but I'm sure they were bored to death in the second half, and I'm sure people wanted more points. But you know what? I'm fine. It won the ball game. Oklahoma showed their dominance tonight. And all this talk about, well, you can't put Oklahoma in the top four. They don't have a championship defense. Well, if you're going off of this week, I don't know if it's a championship defense, but it was pretty solid tonight. And you can't say anything about that. Because TCU's defense got nearly 600 yards put on it tonight. And Oklahoma wasn't even trying in the second half. Not even trying. Just trying to run out the clock. Just dominating. So, I am just, imagine this. This is the first time since, like, what, 2008 when, like, we had, like, literally 2008 when we dominated TCU. First time since 08, like, during the great run that OU had with Bradford and all that great team that they had. That was like a 35-10 game. This was pretty similar. And, you know, and one criticism, I don't like Baker running the ball as much as he did. That's a fair criticism. This guy, you know, every time he gets up and starts limping, you get nervous. And, oh, God, I'm going to do this. Drives you nuts because this, you can't lose him. Like, Riley's got to be smarter than that. There was a point where I agree with a lot of people on Twitter where it's like, it got to a point where OU probably could have put in Kyler Murray, but I don't think Riley's comfortable with that quite yet. Because they were up like 18. I think this the big when TCU scored that second half touchdown, and OU prevented the 2-point conversion. Now that was a big moment too. Little like it kept OU up three scores, and I think that like killed any motivation TCU had the rest of the game as well. So that's a big difference when you keep it from when it's 18 and you prevent it from going to 16. It's a huge swing, and so I think it made it easier for Oklahoma just to keep doing what they were doing, and I'm fine with it. And, you know, I don't know what's going to happen next week. Kansas, I think they'll go up there, and with the way they play tonight, I think they'll handle their business fine. I don't know if they're going to go get a shutout or whatever, but, like, I think they'll be fine. We'll see. But look at it this way. You get to go into next week. Now, not the team, fans. I'm talking as fans, like, because everyone likes to project both sides, like, we can all take a deep breath, relax a little bit, no stress, you know, I don't know what kickoff is yet, but I assume this will be an 11 a.m. kick, and I'm fine with that this week, because I work earlier than usual next week, and I will get home in time to watch it if it is, or 2:33 theater kick, either way, I'm fine. If that's a night game, I'm like, night game. And then you come home to play West Virginia, which is not a gimme. Not by a long shot. Will Greer can play a little bit of football. But we'll cross that bridge when we come to it. Right now, Oklahoma is in a good spot. More than likely on Tuesday, we'll be in the top four. And, you know, it's looking like they may have to play TCU again as well. So, again, we don't know for sure, but got to see. But right now, it looks as if everybody wins out like they should, we will be seeing the Horned Frogs in Arlington, closer to home for them, just like in the Metroplex, the North Texas area. So I'm done here. Oklahoma wins. Dominating victory. I thought this would be similar to last week. And, wow, just like very impressive performance. You can't say anything about it else. I'm done. OU wins, and we're such a good spot right now. Such a good spot. Real quick, Nah, I'll save it for later. Like, you can listen to my thoughts on the podcast or follow me on Twitter at OniKuna. The podcast is at SoonerSportsRadio.com, the C3 Show. Listen. It's awesome. Me and Joe Bettner. Good stuff. All right. Y'all have a good one.